And then just making the temperature checks. There's a mover there actually is not a problem. Both works. It's a draw. Okay, let's go for the next one. White to move. Now queen g2 checkmate is threatening, so we need to be careful about that one. Yeah, black is up a piece, but his pieces are all on the queen side, so it's wow. Feels like white may have some chance here. Ooh, rook e8 check. Knight takes e8, queen h7 check. King takes it's a knight f8 check. King h8, knight g6 check. Wow, this is a nice. It's a perpetual now. Next one, white to move. Oh la la, what's going on here? So actually black has a queen for the rook, so that looks a big advantage. So knight d6 looks kind of logical. Knight d6 check, king d8, rook f8 check, king c7, rook c8 check, then king b6, he runs away. Wow, look at Chad, that's the move. That's beautiful. Yeah, it's sitting actually really checkmate on h8. Captures the knight f6. What if queen b2? Actually, that's the question, if queen b2. To cover in the square. Rook h5, queen b2. Ah, okay, but then it works out in 96. No. Rook h5, queen b2. Knight d6 check, if king d8 that would be nice because then rook h8 check, king c7, rook c8 check, king b6, rook b8 check, and then wins the queen. But after queen b2, knight d6 check, king goes to f8. It's something interesting, not easy. look at how so nice idea. So sad if it's not work. What if knight f6 after that? Knight f6. Hello, hello, guys. Hello. So white wants to save this one. Rook h5 looks like a good move first, but queen b2. The knight f6 check, king d8, rook h8 check, king c7, knight d5 check. King b7. This is very much unlikely. There will be something. Rook h5, queen b2, rook b5. Oh my god, it's the same stuff. If he captures the knight d6, if he's not capturing the rook b8, check with the settlement. Wow. Ha! Huh. Wow. And this is here. Beautiful. Wow. Wow, this is the next second move. It's kind of hard to realize the same thing, like in a symmetrical situation works. Yeah, Black need to make the draw, so himself. Wow, white to move again. So Black has this strong b3 pawn, so white should somehow. Knight takes g6, pawn takes g6, f6, f7 check, king takes f7, rook h7 check, and rook h8, rook h7. This is also a draw, but it's not a draw, like simply playing. No, f7 is not good because then he goes out of the checks. Rook h7, king f8, rook h8, king e7, and he runs out. So this is the only way. Wow, he cannot take it because then even white wins. Go back and check, and it's a draw. Wow. Yeah, you need to check always what your intuition says. Of course, if you have time for that, but it's good to check if really it's a blunder or just a genius move. Okay, Black to move. Probably will sacrifice knight to g5, h to g5, knight to d5. Knight is hanging on c6, so we need to take check. And this is a draw. Okay, let's move on to the next one. Why to move? Wow, it looks like kind of like a stalemate. Bishop f2, bishop f2, then e3 is on the move. Bishop takes e3, queen takes e3, queen f2, you need to capture it, and then a5 check, and then just damn it. Beautiful. Thank you for the follow, thank you. Next move, next one. White to move. Oh my god, it's only pawns left. Black is also a strong pass pawn. Wow, this is the knight. Actually, we get the knight, and the knight c7 check, and it's a wow, it's always a perpetual check with the knight. That's interesting. Okay, let's move on. White to move. So what if you just sacrifice the queen? Yeah, queen takes 8-6, knight takes 8-6, rook takes 8-6, king g7, rook 8-7, check, king f8, rook h8, check, king e7. Rook takes c8, rook takes c8. That seems fine. Because h5 maybe, and then h4 and h5 probably is good enough for maybe for a draw. Maybe not more, but good enough for a draw. Knight to g8. Because actually black is not threatening anything. Knight takes g8, king takes g8, queen takes 8-6. Plan is queen h8, checkmate. If the queen takes g8, then queen takes 8-6. That's a checkmate also. Wow. So this seems just good, knight takes g8. What's this? But it goes to d7. Draw, yeah, if he goes here, that's a mistake, because then, so this is clear, yeah, this is nice, so it's nice draw. I was thinking to winning, actually. Checkmate. Probably a little bit over optimistic. This is hanging. Oh, I missed that was hanging. Okay. This is when I take the eight. It's not good with this. Okay. Now I fully understand. Let's go for the next one. Black to move. Yeah, this would be like a pepper church, check, say a queen sacrifice, that's it. Queen take g3, f take g3, rook. H2, h captures on h2, and then the rook's just giving the pepper church checks. Queen take g3 should be around the same border. Ah, so rook e check, yeah. I really need to take more time now. Yeah, just rook. Rook e just means. So we need to start with the rook capture. He cannot take it because then even black wins. So king. G was necessary, and then now we need to sacrifice because it all comes with checks. Okay, let me look a few more. Black to move, black to move, black to move. So white is an extra pawn, but probably his king is just weak enough to make the draw. Thank you. So how to play? What if like something like knight takes f2? Knight takes f2, if king takes f2, then queen e3 check. Ah, but we cannot take the c1 rook because the e8 rook is ascending. King g2, queen d2 check. Ah, that looks good. Then if king h3, then queen h6 check. King g4, then actually you check me, queen h5, king f4. G5 check, king f5. Looks good. Let's see what happens if he moves here. Yeah, and the rook joins the party. It's a nice one actually. Yeah, please try to put all of these exercises and these ideas into practice and draw your lost games and all other games, try to win. Thank you for the support. Thank you for following me. Thank you for the donations. Thank you for subscribing to the channel.